The prison cell that I was in Vietnam was 8 feet long and 8 feet wide. I could pace 3 steps in one direction before I ran into a wall. Then I had the opportunity of turning around and pacing 3 steps the other way. Inside my new little home, I had nothing to do. I had no books to read, no window to look out, no TV, telephone, radio, didn't have a pencil or a piece of paper for 2,103 days. Now, I'd been a very active person, like each of you. On the go all the time, type A behavior, searching for an extra 15 minutes a week to call my mom, and suddenly I had 24 hours a day for the next 6 years. I mean, these bullets are whizzing by. Take a deep breath. Got about half of it out. I bowed my head. And I talked to my Lord. I asked him for a little extra strength that day. I looked back on that prayer many times for myself while I was in the prison camp. Well, why didn't you try to make a deal with God, you know, promise him you'll go back through the ministry or be a good person the rest of your life. But I didn't even think of that. I just prayed for the guts it was going to take to survive whatever challenge the Lord had in store for me. And about that time, I hit the ground. Sunk about waist deep in a rice paddy. I was descended upon by about a zillion of the enemy. They stripped me of everything I had. They took my flight gear, my clothing, my personal possessions. They even took my name. They gave me a name from their language just to humiliate me for the next 6 years. Dragged me around village to village, camp to camp, finally into Hanoi, where I was tortured for 2 days and tossed into this little cell. Thirty feet long and 20 feet wide. Each had 14 inches of bed space, I remember. Whenever you wanted to roll over, you had to holler at everybody else and wake everybody else because you had to roll over in unison. It didn't work. How do you survive this? What kind of stuff do you have in your gut? Moment in my life, I'm losing track. I don't know if it's a real memory anymore, what's a hallucination. I need a baseline. I need to validate my sanity. I think I can call each of you a parachute packer. I'll explain that to you. My wife and I sat down in a restaurant not so long ago, about 2 tables over. A guy kept looking at me. He pointed his finger at me and said, "You're Plum." I said, "Yes, sir, I'm Plum." He said, "But you're that guy. You flew jet fighters in Vietnam. You're a fighter pilot." I said, "That's right." He said, "Part of that Top Gun outfit shot down off the aircraft carrier Kitty Hawk. You parachuted in the enemy hands. You spent 6 years as a prisoner of war." Somewhat dumbfounded, I looked at this guy and I said, "How in the world did you know all that?" He chuckled and he smiled and he said, "Because I packed your parachute." He came up with just the proper words. The guy grabbed my arm and he said, "I guess it worked." I said, "Sure did, pal. And I must tell you, I've said a lot of prayers of thanks for your nimble fingers, but I didn't realize I'd have the opportunity of expressing my gratitude in person." I said, "Let me ask you a question. Do you keep track of all the parachutes you pack? Do you know of all the lives you've saved?" He said, "No, I don't keep track of all the parachutes I pack. It's enough gratification for me just to know that I've served." There's a sailor in the bowels of an aircraft carrier. The guy stands there at a long wooden table and he weaves his shrouds and he folds the silks of these parachutes 8, 10, 12 hours a day. Here's jet jockeys. The Top Gun zooming around the sky. could not have cared less about the guy down there in the hole. Until one day my parachute came along and passed mine up to me. Question becomes, who packs your parachute? Who do you look to for strength in time of need? Maybe more importantly, who looks to you for that kind of parachute packing?